الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى يا ربي لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين اللهم ارزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته اللهم أحينا على سنته وتوفنا على ملته وأوردنا حوضه واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا ثم ما بعد my dear respected brothers and sisters and last week I was reflecting on this particular hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه The Prophet ﷺ said that كل سلامة من الناس عليه صدقة كل يوم تطلع فيه الشمس Which means that every sulama, every bone of every person owes sadaqah each day in which the sun rises. In another narration, they said, Ya Rasulullah, we cannot, not everybody can pay a sadaqah or a charity for every bone we have. We have about 360 bones in our bodies, connected together amazingly with joints and muscles. In a way that make us move and do what we do every single day easily. But sometimes we take it for granted. We don't think about it. We don't think about what it means to be able to walk, to be able to raise your hand, to be able to capture things, to be able to give or take, to be able to play sports, easy sports, or tennis, or soccer, or anything. We take it for granted because we got used to it. Our muscles work perfectly, our bones are okay, our joints are intact. But very few people thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for these blessings. So last Sunday I was biking with my friends and something happened. So I feel my left shoulder, as you can see, is not a pleasant experience. It's not fun, very painful. So the first time in my life I heard about something called AC joints that connect the collarbone with the shoulder blade. I've never heard about it, but when this accident happened, when this injury happened, I started searching. Of course, I saw doctors and so on, did x-ray, but I noticed how this collarbone and the shoulder blade are amazingly connected together so that we can move our hands and our shoulder. So many muscles and nerves and joints work together just to do simple act. And only when we have some pain, when we go through accidents or we feel the injury, now we realize how our life is difficult. This is exactly what I went through. Just to be able to make wudu on my own, to wash my face with my two hands, it's not easy. To take off and on my clothes, put on my clothes, is not that simple anymore. That's all because one of these joints were broken. And I've been told that you just need to wait for 3 months and it will heal on its own. Of course, the option to go with surgery is there, but I prefer not to do surgery since it's going to heal, inshallah. Inshallah. I need your dua because I'm going for Hajj this year, inshallah, soon. So I remember this beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam who reminds us you should pay sadaqah every single day for the bones and the joints you have in your body that you enjoy every single day with which you can go and work and earn money and you know enjoy your life. How to do that? How can we pay 360 charities every single morning? And the Prophet, peace be upon him, explain to us the comprehensive meaning of charity. It's not just giving money. Giving money is one form of giving charity. But he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said everybody can and should give charity every single, no matter how poor you are, how low your income. And he said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, تَعْدِلُ بَيْنَ اثْنَيْنِ صَدَقَةً To apply or to serve justice between people, that's sadaqah. To help someone to ride his mount, sadaqah, or to carry the luggage of someone who cannot carry it for himself, that is sadaqah. A good word is sadaqah. كلمه الطيبه. Right? To say good words. Assalamu alaikum, how are you? You look good. May Allah bless you. All these are good words. This good word is a sadaqah. So the Rasulullah ﷺ wants us to always use our tongue in a way that produces good words. And this counts as ibadah, as sadaqah. Allah is happy with you when you say these good words. And of course the opposite is true. Bad words count as sin. وَبِكُلِّ خُطْوَةٍ تَمْشِيهَا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ صَدَقَةٍ Every step you take towards the masjid to perform salah is sadaqah, believe it or not. When you come to the masjid, every step you take counts as sadaqah. وَتُمِيتُ الْأَذَى عَنِ الطَّرِيقِ صَدَقَةً To remove any bone or harmful thing from the road of the people is sadaqah. We see something that's harmful and you remove it so that people don't slip or don't fall down. It is sadaqah. This happened frequently in Michigan weather, as we all know. To remove, to clean the way for the people, to see something harmful, to just take it and remove it. That is sadaqah. So every Muslim should always think about how many sadaqah I want to do today. And that is the practical way to thank Allah for the bones and the joints you have in your body. That makes you able to move. If you are now, right now, pain-free, be so thankful because others are suffering severe pain. If you walked from the parking lot to here, be so thankful that you can walk. If you are sitting comfortably now, be so thankful because others cannot sit the way you are sitting now. The fact that you are able to come to the masjid is a great blessing because others could not make it because they are physically unable. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in this beautiful, authentic hadith narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, he wants to educate his companions, and of course every one of us, that you should always think about what you can give, not what you can take. You should be a giver, whether you are wealthy or not. Another hadith, كُلُّ تَسْبِيحَةٍ صَدَقَةٍ Every time you say Subhanallah, that is sadaqah. وَكُلُّ تَحْمِيدَةٍ صَدَقَةٍ Every time you say Alhamdulillah, that is sadaqah. Every time you say La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, that is sadaqah. But the Muslim should always be active, should always be concerned about others, should always worry and think about serving the community. Yes, the wealthy can give more of their money because they have more, but even those who don't have enough to spend, don't have enough money to spend, they have so many other things to spend. If Allah blessed you with knowledge, share this knowledge with others. If Allah give you experience, share this experience with others. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you some wisdom, share this wisdom with others. If Allah give you time, use this time by helping others. So every one of us should think about how many sadaqas we should give. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says twice in the Quran, وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا And if you try to number Allah's blessings, you could not ever count them. We cannot, because we are not even aware about these joints. Unless you get injured, then you know about this joint. وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا If you try to count the blessings of Allah, you will never be able to count them. There are so many, many of them you are not even aware of. So what should we do? How to be thankful to Allah if we cannot count His blessings? Do what Rasulullah ﷺ advised us to do. Give these sadaqas. And in another narration he said, ﷺ, and what suffices all these forms of sadaqah is to pray two rak'ah of al-duha between the sunrise and dhuhr time. To pray at least two rak'ah called salat al-duha, that is sufficient. So when you pray these two rak'ahs in this time, any time between the sunrise and dhuhr time, that as if you paid a charity on behalf of every joint and every bone you have in your body. Isn't this a good idea? You don't want to wait until you are injured to realize the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But be thankful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are able to move. Pray two rak'ahs. These two rak'ahs between sunrise and dhuhr prayer are sufficient. It can be two, four, or six, or eight, but at least you pray over two rak'ahs. One of the adhkar we say in the morning and the evening are amazing because the Prophet ﷺ said, if you say this in the morning, then you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings He gave you on that day. And if you say this in the evening, then you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all blessings He bestowed upon you in the evening. And this dua in the morning, we should say, whatever blessing I or anyone of your creator attain in the morning is from you alone, without any partner to you. And so yours is the praise and yours is the thanks. اللهم ما أصبح بي من نعمة أو بأحد من خلقك فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك فلك الحمد ولك الشكر. Whatever a blessing that those that we know about and those that we don't even know about, those that we can realize and those we cannot realize. Any blessing that I or any one of your creature, whatever blessing I or any one of your creature attained today, this morning, comes only, exclusively from you. It's all praise due to you, all thanks due to you. So when we say this in the morning, then we pay thanks for all blessings we enjoyed on that day, and we say this in the evening, we pay thanks for everything we enjoyed, every blessing we enjoyed in that night. Brothers and sisters, remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in one of the short surahs most of us memorize, Surah At-Takathur, Al-Hakum At-Takathur, Hatta Zurtum Al-Maqabir. In the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. Then you will be asked that day, the day of judgment, about the pleasures you enjoyed. One of the things we know for sure that we'll be asked about on the day of judgment, about the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did you do with this blessing? Hadith in Sahih Muslim, Allah will bring people to Him. And Allah will remind him of His blessings. I give you this money, I give you this fame, I give you this health, I give you this career, I give you this money, I give you this family. What did you do with this? One day, the Prophet, peace be upon him, was so hungry. There's no food in his house, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he went out hoping that one of his companions may invite him. And then he saw Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu arda, who was also extremely hungry. There was lack of food in Medina at that time. So he asked, what brought you out in this hour? Before Dhuhr, it's very hot at that time. Usually people stay home. Rasulullah said, what brought you out is what brought me out. Nothing but hunger. And then Umar came, radiallahu anhu arda, for the same reason, they're all hungry. So the Prophet ﷺ said, let's go and visit our brother so-and-so has a farm. Maybe he can provide something for us. And Rasulullah ﷺ went and said, As-salamu alaykum. And this Sahabi was extremely happy. And he welcomed Rasulullah, Abu Bakr and Umar into his farm. And he rushed to his family and asked him to prepare a good meal for them. And they did prepare some meat and bread, fresh bread, and, you know, relatively cold water, and they ate from this. Some date, and Rasulullah ﷺ put some meat on a loaf of bread, and he said to someone, can you please send this to my daughter Fatima, because she did not eat meat for so long. That is Rasulullah ﷺ, the most honored person in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, going to one of his friends, hoping just to get some food. And he sent this to Fatima Zahra, one of the best women Allah have ever created, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when they finished this meal, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions, wallahi, by Allah, you will be asked about this na'im in the day of judgment. This meal, cold water, wallahi, you will be asked about this, whether you've been thankful or not. How many times we eat and even forget to say Alhamdulillah after we finish this meal? Because again, Alhamdulillah, abundance of food, so we don't think about those who are dying out of starvation. Those who have no access to pure, clean water. We take it for granted. So brothers and sisters will be asked about the na'im. Part of this na'im is our body and how our body functions. How our body is beautifully structured and functions. It's a great na'im. And if you want to understand this na'im, look at those who have been deprived from these blessings. Say, Alhamdulillah alladhi afana. Praise be to Allah, who grant us well-being. Give us afiyah. We will be asked about these joints, about these bones, the ability to walk and talk. we will be asked about this. The meaning of this hadith, brothers and sisters, is that we should think about thanking Allah practically for the, all these blessings He has given us, especially our bones and our joints. Orthopedics will like to hear this khutbah. It's a great blessing, and perhaps we need to listen to an orthopedic about how our body functions, just to see the amazing structure of our body and how it functions. To be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هو الذي أنشأكم وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة يا أيها الإنسان ما غرك بربك الكريم الذي خلقك فسواك فعدلك في أي صورة ما شاء ربك ركبك. Oh man, what has deluded you in respect of your noble Lord? He who created you and formed you and proportioned you and assembled you in a whatever way He willed. What deluded you about this Lord and Creator who created you in such fashion, fashioned you in such amazing, functionable way? It is Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, who gave you the ability to hear and to see and to think. Hearing and seeing and intellect. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. You may be thankful. If you use your sight and your hearing and your intellect, you will, should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the reality is, Allah said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ. Very few among my servants are thankful. Very few who thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the tremendous blessings He blessed us with. So brothers and sisters, my message today is that we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings that we are aware of and the blessings that we are not even aware of. Pray these two rak'ah every morning. Think of giving as many sadaqah as possible every single day. Thank Allah with your tongue by saying Alhamdulillah, and thank Allah practically by praying these rak'ahs or giving sadaqahs to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our health and our wealth and our families and our community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us afwa and afiyah in this life and the life after. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد أما بعد إن شاء الله very quick announcements that we'll have the Hajj workshop on July 19th إن شاء الله after صلاة المغرب. So for those who are going for Hajj this year, inshallah, it's important to attend this workshop to get to know the basics of Hajj. And if you have any questions, inshallah, you can bring it with you. The monthly dinner is supposed to be last Saturday, but in July, it's always take place in the second Saturday. So tomorrow, inshallah, is the monthly dinner. Also, we are honored today to have our dear brother, Anas Kantar, who is an NBA superstar, plays for Boston Celtics. And he is part of this basketball camp that will take place in Avondale after Salat al-Jumma. So I used to think that I'm tall, but when I stood next to him, I found that I'm not as tall as I thought. So mashallah, may Allah bless him, may Allah bless his health, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him a very good example for our youth. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إنا نسألك رزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا. أصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا. اللهم اجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث فأصلح لنا شأننا كله. اللهم لا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا إلى أحد من الناس يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء ونسألك الغنى عن الناس يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا مرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا موتى المسلمين وانصر الاسلام واعز المسلمين. اللهم يسر لنا حج بيتك الحرام وزياره نبيك عليه الصلاه والسلام. اللهم اصلح لنا شاننا كله. اللهم لا تكلنا الى انفسنا طرفه عين ولا الى احد من الناس يا رب العالمين. اللهم اعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم انا نسالك من الخير كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله واصحابه اجمعين اقم الصلاه